the dawn of capitalism, when corporations as mighty as nations rule the seas and dominate the world's valuable trade routes. With an iron fist, they forge a path of tyranny and exploitation, igniting a battle for global supremacy. From the Indian Ocean, a flood of exotic goods feed new addictions and fill coffers with coins tainted in blood. And where there is blood, there are predators.
Thank you. The British and the folk beat them. I blame Captain Rust for steering us into these cursed shallows.
We survived the battle, and now you arrive to help through the Dao. I would say our fortune's on the rise, no? There's a certain yearning in your eyes. I've seen the same glint in others before. I'm sure you will steer us through to Sainte-Anne.
To reach Pirate Paradise, we must first know the way.
Yeah. A logbook we retrieved from the wreck. More than ink and parchment, our fates are revealed in layers and often from plain sight. Perhaps this will help you chart your path forward, friend.
Make yourself useful. Take the tiller before the damn British return. I'll work the sail.
The wind favors the fearless. Let us chase it. Among the scattered survivors, one must surely know the way to Sainte-Anne. Freeman's luck, guide us. Go even faster. Trim the sails. Watch out for those teeth.
Tell me you're not part of wrestler's group. You are a passenger, like me. Yes. We were five in the dhow after the wreck. Then the sharks came. It happened so fast. Wrestler's crew didn't help us. They even laughed. It is too late for me. But maybe you will walk on the free shores of Sainte-Anne.
A broken mast on that island. Could there be survivors? Land ahead! Destiny's thrown us a line.
We can find help to get out of this place.
Captain Rassler, the ship was as overburdened as a pregnant sow. We may have lost the British in the fog, but also the race against these cursed elements. See now, the Exeter's guts spilled across these shallows, and I'm surrounded by drunken sluggards who believe they are doomed to this hellish rock. And where were you, Captain, while the Exeter was hounded by British frigates? No doubt cowering in your quarters like the filthy bilge rat you are. What good are your foolhardy ways if they have left us stranded upon these shallows? You wish to reach Sainte-Anne? Of course you do. And so do the rest of this drunken lot, sprawled upon their asses. But if we return to the Kingpin empty-handed, he will surely strip us of our titles if he does not first strip us of our skin. Retrieve what remains of Scurlock's cargo from the shark-infested waters. Only then will I divulge the way to pirate paradise. Good. Now make haste.
Get to work, sluggards! I'm still in charge.
Wouldn't trust the officer to guide a fish in open seas, but if the bugger knows the way to Sainte-Anne, we need to get to the lock's cargo. We can hunt these fish for food.
You must track fast!
Those corpses, We might have to search them. Good work. I think we have enough.
We are too tired, Captain!
The way to Sainte-Anne. Get me Skellock's. Thanks for the goods. Skellock may well spare my head, but I cannot say the same for you. After I tell him about the captain who failed to protect his cargo. Find your own way to Sainte-Anne, chum sniffer. I don't owe you a sliver up your ass, especially when mine's on the line. Why don't you ask Captain Rassler? His bloated corpse might know the way. Now fuck off, bilge rat!
Little weasel to the very end. If the bastard says Wrestler might have the map to Saint Anne, we should search his wreck. Horizon might hold the sunrise I've been yearning for.
Better hope the pirates don't slap you in the back first!
Freeman's luck indeed. He found a way to Sainte-Anne and a letter bearing Skurlock's mark. The Kingpin will surely want to know what happened to his cargo.
Or Jones Carroll. We'll have 3 shots from a flintlock wizard for our heads.
Or just yours, friend. What's a pirate's life without a little peril and mischief, eh? With the cargo from the Exeter lost, Skurlock will need a daring rogue like yourself to procure new goods for his pirate empire. And so far, your fortune has steered us through. I'm glad we pulled your cop from the sea, friend. Wrestler is dead, and with him, all prior obligations and duties. You are free to make your own luck now, Captain.
Captain, is it? As long as you don't scare us into the blasted rocks.
Finally getting out of these cursed angels. Fortune smiles upon you, Captain. Something tells me we're going to be just fine. I think I might even stick around for a while. Imagine what else we could accomplish together, Captain. We could build a strong fleet and crush our enemies, conquer any threat. We could defy the gods themselves. Onwards to Sainte-Anne, Captain.
Make way! Set sail for pirate paradise!
Smell that salt, spice, and sin, Captain. The Indian Ocean holds many secrets and mysteries. The smuggling den of Sainte-Anne is one of its hidden gems. Whatever a pirate needs, this place has it in stock. Sainte-Anne is where we turn our luck into fortune, friend. Skurlock can get us started. That letter is proof you're a pirate worth a lick of salt. Hey, don't look at me. You're the best pirate to win Skurlock over. Me? I had my shot in the past. We don't need Skurlock's loyalty to gain infamy and influence. Only his connections. A proper ship would be a start, unless you want to keep cozying up on your dhow. I'll stay by the ship while you tread shore. Pay no mind to the bottom feeders, Captain. Remember, we answer only to the winds of fate.
This one isn't gonna make it. The little twig will snap within days.
Days? That carcass is just about falling apart. And reeks of whale.
You're one of the survivors from the shipwreck. Your situation must have improved if you're here for storage space. Like a hard-working ant, you can never be too organized. For storage needs. Come again.
More drinks washed away.
The best way to get in Skirmisher is a show.
This one here survived the wreck.
Sure looks like it.
A survivor? Come on in, Callie.
Get it done. We'll never show your ugly mug again. You useless git. The British wrecked my ship, sank my cargo, but shut you out! Hope you're not worthless. I really needed those goods. You see, this port rises on Julian's patronage. And so rich it pisses liquid gold. All I receive is a letter. That fucker wipes his ass to smear my face. I send a full haul of goods and his demands triple. I'll need more captains. Nose for a bargain, have you? I can set you up with some traders, but you'll need a much larger hold. Cully, I saw that little tub you pushed up in. It's halfway to Flotsam. You've got spirits, but you're not ready yet. Now you want to get out of those rags and into a real ship, then build your reputation and earn the people's respect. Good things will follow. You do that, and I can make you the most infamous pirate in all the seas. Off you go. We'll see each other soon.
So you're the kelp that washed ashore from the wreck of the Exeter. Skurlock may see potential in you, but all I see is a would-be pirate with salt in their breeches. Tell me, what does the pirate king see in someone as ragged as yourself? Would others sail with a captain with one leaky boat to their name? But if you prove your worth, even the waves will bend to your will. I expect you'll be wanting a pat on the back, treasure in your boots, and John Skellock's warm embrace. Ha! Sainte-Anne would sooner slit your throat than be called your paradise. I can build you the mightiest ship in the Indian Ocean, like I did for Skurlock with his Margareta. But how you steer it into the waves is up to you, Captain. A pirate steers their own ship, but how it fares in a monsoon depends on its maker. Visit my friend, Zane, the carpenter, and he will help you craft the tools needed for harvesting shipbuilding materials. Thank you. Come back again.
Ujambo. You have been floating on a splinter of luck so far. To carve a reputation here, you must get your hands bloody. It's the pirate's way. If you measure infamy by the weight of your purse, Sainte-Anne is the right place. We can help each other. You bring me quality materials and I'll make you the best tools on the Red Isle. That way, both our names will grow. I'm always here.
Feels good to get decent meat.
You got a bigger ship ready, Captain. I don't want to have to haul you from the sea again.
Captain.
pesky little dirt dog.
If Skurlock vouches for you, then we can do business. I was worried you would not make it back. Continue like this, mate, and fortune will surely come your way. You are one step closer to securing your own vessel. You have come many leagues since searching for scraps on the coast. If you have the silver, I will gladly sell you designs stolen from mercantile docks. With the right materials, you can build a ship to rival their best. A ship to call your own and a shoreline calling to good fortunes. Speak to Thomas, the blacksmith, next. Unless you plan on ramming your vessel into the next company boat, he will build you cannons to sink your enemies instead.
I normally wouldn't give a nobody like you the steam off my piss on a good day. But I saw your ship's got nothing sticking out of her gunports. Listen, surviving in pirate wars demands you swim with sharks. If that chills your blood, paddle off to your backwater pond. The Exeter crash has left us short on supplies. The company knows this, so they're squeezing us tighter. Bring me supplies and I'll build you weapons to skewer those frogs. Before you can take a bite out of the company, you'll need to have teeth. Right now, you're toothless. You need provisions. You'll have to get them yourself. Now, get cracking, mate. Even the sea would have given you a wave. I'll build you a fine weapon. Careful not to blow your foot off. I do miss Bristol. These fiery cannons, they'll pierce through those dainty company hulls. So, you got your decks scrubbed, cannons swabbed, and your loins girded. Good. It's time you rumble to the company ships. The cocky pricks keep helping themselves to my iron. Blast them to bits.
Spyglass so we can identify those French leeches. We have a ship to sink! Au travail!
Got that!
It's a fix! Blacksmith of Sainte-Anne tries to reshape his soul.
Your infamy rises.
How fares your day, pirate? Those frogs barely put up a fight, eh? You did good, mate. Tales of your victory grow taller with every telling. Now you've impressed the other pirates in Sainte-Anne. They're looking to deal with you. I've also got more jobs if you're up to it. This next job will be brutal, but pull through and even Skurlock shall hear of it. See? Companion warships carry rare parts that I would pay well for. Sink the ships and the sea will swallow those parts. You'll need to board the ships.
A growing pirate needs more space. Come back anytime.
What the fuck you mean he wrecked his ship in the water?
Thomas the blacksmith is picky with his customers. Why waste one's talent on the unworthy, right?
We will get the goods rapidly and be back safe at there.
Angalia, Captain! The crew got fiber!
Slowly now! It won't be easy!
Prepare to engage!
Another bottom feeder.
How fares your day, pirate? I thought you'd wilt, thought you'd cower, but you've proven me dead wrong, mate. You butchered Company's warships and gird their olds, just like a proper pirate would. You tormented the Compagnie, rose in infamy, and earned the respect of your fellow pirates. But you look like shite, mate. Seek out Florentine at the Atelier and she'll garb you up good.
Here for a restyle, mon coeur? I can tell from a glance you're not a normal pirate. Come, Florentine d'Alesso will turn your life around with fashion to fit your rising fame. A jute dress could be lovely. Thank you. My father will be surprised when I next return with a ship full of dresses. You've got a good eye. As your reputation grows, remember to ensure your style keeps up.
I'll build you a fine weapon. Careful not to blow your foot up. So, you've been to the atelier. But clothes aren't all that make the pirate. If you want to rise above the rest, build your infamy. Opportunities of greater reward and risk shall come your way. If any pose too fierce a challenge, I'll forge you something deadlier. Keep cracking, and even kingpins like Scurlock will take notice. The company! Take back what's ours! Remember, we never talk. Hey, better watch your mouth in there.
Thanks to Captain Fuck Up here, I got a French hound sniffing right up my sweaty asshole. Get him out of my sight. I could really use a new captain now. Heard you swap that leaky tub of yours. The talk of your deeds grows louder. You see my ships in the harbor. Do you know where they're headed? Holds brimming with spices, amber grease, and other delights. They make passage for New York. And in return, the slobber-faced Tulin gives me all the silver, supplies, and guns I need. As long as that flesh pile gets his goods, I can do whatever I want on this island. I control the flow of coin, so I bow down to none. You seek fortune with me, and we shall reap spoils greater than the wealth of nations. Survive, and you'll grow so powerful we could be partners. Or rivals. You want this chance, Cully. It's yours. But don't you give me reason to ruin another rug. Those fineries are getting very costly. Now take a job and shove off. I want you to haul some guns to my allies, the Sea People. They have information on offer. Bring it back. Now, the Sea People and I have a deal. They get the weapons they need from me, and I get full reign of this port. They have been long at war with the clan of Farah, so watch your ass. Farah ships will be on the hunt for you. I don't care who wins. Every day, I make a killing selling these guns. Why bleed for others when you could suck them dry? Some of the Sea People trade goods. Others offer information. As long as the war drags on, the agreement stands. So, bring him enough arms to fight, but never to dominate. We got ourselves a money spinner, Cully. Let's keep it turning. Keep that fire burning.